good one on our hands in the first semi-final of CPL. Back to the beginning, where a 110 run fourth wicket partnership between Ross Taylor and Darren Bravo revived Trinidad and Tobago Red Steel's innings after they were sent into bat in the first semi-final of that let me call CPL. Jamaica Talawas had reduced the Red Steel to 36 for 3 at one stage, but Taylor with 70 and Bravo with 33 led the recovery as the guys got up to 155. Dave Bernard Jr. was the early wrecker for the Talawas. He had 3 for 19. Here are the highlights.
Oh, nicely played by O'Brien. Very nice, very nicely held by Chris Gayle.
And this is a great shot just to wind it up.
Get him. Over the top, not controlled, gets away with it and he gets 4.
4 for 1 at the moment. He's got that away quite nicely and he's picked out the man beautifully. Whipped away, but he's picked him out again. Wow, that is unbelievable. Nice and fine, that's nicely played. That's going to pick up 4 runs. Crunch that one through the covers, that is a beautiful shot. It doesn't come much better than that. Tries of catch it, but it's going to have to be someone in the dugout.
It's 4, short and wide. Doesn't perfectly time that, but it's run away for 4.
Room sliced away. Jerome chases him. Runs. And again, has he got all of it? It nearly came up here. He's hit it straight up, but the breeze is going to help. And it races away for 4. Fizzing away behind point. You miss your length, and that's what happens. 4 off 3. Certainly got to back the batting side. Tehran. And he goes up and over. Oh, classy way to finish it, folks. He's at a maximum. And isn't he pumped? It's Rusty Tehran. And Andre Russell have done the job. They put on 82 in just 40 deliveries. Extraordinary scenes here. They were dead and buried at 76 for 6 for the Talawas. They've got up and smoked it with a couple of deliveries to spare him.
Take your hats off to the Jamaican Talawas. Spare a thought for the Trinidad and Tobago Red Steel. We've seen an exciting game of cricket in front of us.
Well, just in case you're a bit confused there, we went live to the feed and you saw just now that the Talawas came back to win, scoring 158 for 6 to eliminate the Trinidad Red Steel. Of course, we'll have all, well, not just the highlights, we'll have the play that you missed, tape delayed for you right after the evening news, and we'll have highlights during CBC Sports at 8:35 p.m. Staying with cricket, two-time defending Lyme under 15 cricket champions Combermere seem to be heading back to another final. On day one of their semi-final game at the Pine Basin, Combermere gained a relatively healthy first innings lead over the Allen School. CBC Shane Jones reports on Combermere's first innings.
Combermere's innings began in disaster. Cheyenne Brathwaite caught by Kerry Justin off Nathan Maynard in the very first over. Then in Maynard's second over, he got another. Shaquille Marshall fending off. Easy catch for wicketkeeper Seeley, gone for 3. The defending champs 10 for 2. And the wickets continue to tumble. David Scott thought he had 4 here. Good catch by Meshack Maynard off Rashawn York on his way for 4. While Kofi Jilks came in and got going, pulling this long hop behind square for 4. The next man to go was Indal Prasad. Good catch by Alex Seeley off D'Angelo Springer, 37 for 4 now. Another wicket thrown away, too easy. Zidane Clark caught by York off Springer for a duck. Jolts was still there, playing his shots, left leg out of the way, and 6 big ones off Justin. But then he had to go. Super catch by Maynard off Elijah Hoyt. Jilks made 22. Avery Chandler added some fire at the end of the innings. Got all of this one maximum. But he was the last to go. Run out for 17 in the final over. Combermere 106 all out. Shane Jones, CBC Sports.
Well, thanks, Shane. Allen, in reply, didn't back up their bowlers, being dismissed for just 38 in 32.1 overs. That's a lead of 68 for the champs, who were led by Indal Prasad, who took 3 for 9, and Lamar Springer, 2 for 8. Meanwhile, in the other semi at Friendship, Queen's College have a slight lead over the Lodge. Lodge batted first and made 142 for 8 in 32 overs after being 42 for 5 at one stage. Frederick Griffith top scored with 53, while Ajani Batson took 5 for 28. QC in reply are 159 for 4. National under 15 batsman Ajani Waterman is still there on 71, while teammate Nico Reefer made 40. Both matches conclude tomorrow. Still in cricket, Jamaica are again the champions of the WICB Women's Super 50. In a one-sided affair at Windsor Park in Dominica today, Jamaica smashed 309 for 7 in their 50 overs, with Natasha McLean falling 6 short of her 100, while Chanel Henry made 85. Guyana were then dismissed for 89 in their 30th over for the defending champs to win by a massive 220 runs. Meanwhile, Barbados finished outside of the medals as they lost the third place playoff to rivals Trinidad and Tobago. TNT batted first at the Botanical Gardens and completed their 50 overs on 183 for 6. Stacey Ann King top scored with 63, while Aaliyah Aline took 3 of those 6 wickets. Barbados women then could only manage 107 in 32.4 to lose by 76 runs. Deandra Dottin got 31 and Kaisia Knight 28. And Barbados lost their final preliminary game today in the WICB on the 19 one-day tournament in Guyana. They were up against the hosts, who scored 298 for 5 in their 50 overs, led by 2 century makers. Shimron Hetmeyer made 123, while Tajnarine Chandpaul got 103 not out. The Bajan skipper Joshua Drakes took 2 for 22. Barbados on the 19s were then dismissed for 254 in their 50. Drakes did the business again, this time with the bat, top scoring with 75, while Lee Jamon Gaskin got 69. Shiraz Ramcharan took 4 for 59. Well, the teams began arriving today for this week's start of the World Council of Domino Federation 16th World Championships. The organizing committee has been hard at work getting things together. Gregory Blayman, the first vice president of the WCDF, says there will be over 100 participants.
They will bring in pretty large contingents, but we only have 4 countries coming in, namely Angola, and that will be their contingent of 26 persons. Then we have Antigua, who will bring in 32. Guyana will 33 persons, along with their officials that they'll be sending up officials as well. And then we also have the USA, who will bring in the biggest team for the tournament for the first time in the number 28. And Barbados contingent is usually the biggest. We are home, so we even take full advantage of the full numbers. Barbados is defending champions, and they will be hosting about 40 persons in the contingent.
The competition will be intense, and Blemmons says local domino fans will get a taste of different styles.
This tournament is a non-signing tournament. I know most people like they see that dominoes are this shake up and egg shoulders and thing, not this tournament. The guys are more technical in their display. They send the message across the table, but they're coded. So if you come, you will see a different style of dominoes to what you will see play on the local market. So it's going to be a very high level of domino. Barbados main contenders will be coming out of Antigua. Antigua will be there this year, and they've been practicing morning, noon, and night because Antigua has beaten St. Lucia and Dominica. And the only team left in the range to beat would be Barbados. And they said they're going to do it at this tournament. So that will be the keenest competition.
The tournament starts with the opening ceremony on Friday evening at 5:30 at Sea Rocks Dome at the Barbados Beach Club. On Saturday, there'll be the all-day Kisun Polarama from 9 in the morning. And then the World Championships will start in earnest on Sunday afternoon from 2. Around 40 National Sports Council campers got their first taste of a new sport when the Barbados Rugby Football Union staged Get into rugby. CBC's Marsha Boyce was at the Lime Ground.
The ages of 7 and 16 were under the guidance of members of the various Barbados senior rugby 7s and 15s teams, including Kevin Murrell and Brian Cummins. The session, which lasted for about 90 minutes, focused on the basics of the sport.
The session today was just an introduction to rugby. It's not really going into the in-depth of the rules of rugby, because there are a lot of rules. It's just to show the kids another way, another sport that they can play, that they can have fun and do.
Basically, we just played a little, we call it rugby netball, just passing the ball to each other, passing around. We're just trying to get the guys to recognize space, you know what I mean? And being able to hear people calling for the ball, run to space and look for space. But for the most part, everybody was just enjoying it.
The campers liked their introduction to rugby.
It was great. I learned how to throw the ball and some kick it.
I like when the coaches came and they were helping us to learn more about rugby.
I learned how to pass and, well, you don't have to tackle anybody specially.
This was the second of three Get Into Rugby sessions, and Murrell is seeing some potential among the campers he's worked with so far.
They can evade, they can catch, they can pass, they can make difficult passes, and I think that's a good thing. So there are people who can play rugby. After this, we just want to build the awareness of rugby in Barbados, because we would like to start to do programs that bring younger children so they can see what rugby is and they can get involved. This program is really just to build awareness and to get people interested.
Marsha Boyce, CBC Sports.